Okay, let's solve the numerical problem which will illustrate the procedure used for the skirt design. So in this case, we have been given a problem which defines the data which is required for the design. So I just copied this data onto my calculation sheet, and from which we will proceed further. So here we are having a vessel which is having a diameter of 3000 millimeters. The vessel thickness is given as 10 thick, and the height of vessel is given as 45 meters. The operating weight of the vessel is given as 2500 kilonewtons. The empty weight is 1750 kilonewton. This is required for the anchor bolt designs. This is the minimum weight which is there. The wind pressure is defined in two zones. For height more than 20 meters, you are having 1500 newton per meter square, and height less than 20 meters, we are having 1000 newton per meter square. So here, for the simplicity sake, only two sections are defined. In actual case, there will be multiple number of sections. The seismic zone is defined as a moderate zone for getting the seismic coefficient. The permissible stresses in the skirt, tensile is 140 MPa and compressive is 60 MPa. So note that this compressive allowable stress in practice, in actual case, it depends on the skirt thickness. So it depends on TSK, which we don't know. So it is sort of an iterative process. So you have to calculate TSK, then calculate the allowable stress, and then compare whether it is safe or not safe. So it goes in iteration. So in this case, to avoid that, we have been given the direct allowable compressive stress independent of the skirt thickness. The base plate allowable stress is given as 157.5 newton per millimeter square. The anchor bolt stress is given as 105 MPa, and for concrete foundation, the allowable stress is given as 20 MPa. So in this case, the procedure what we'll be following is we'll have to find what is the skirt thickness, then what is the base plate thickness, and then the size and number of anchor bolts. So in this case, we have to assume some diameter of the skirt. So I'm assuming here the diameter of the skirt, DSK, equal to same as the vessel. So that is 3000 millimeters. So one can do some correction here, but or some other value can be taken and you can do the calculations. So we are proceeding with DSK as 3000 millimeters. So the first calculation we will have to do is stresses due to dead weight. So this is given as FD, which is W divided by pi DSK TSK. So in our case, the W, which is the operating weight, is given as 2500 newtons divided by pi multiplied by DSK. We are assumed as 3000 and TSK is unknown. So we'll get FD in terms of TSK as 265.3 divided by TSK. So that is the first calculation. The second one, we have to calculate the wind load stresses. So first we have to calculate what are the wind stresses, wind load, then wind moment, and then wind load stresses. So wind load on any section, ith section, is given as the factor K1, the factor K2 multiplied by Pi, the wind pressure at a particular zone multiplied by the height and outside diameter of the vessel at that particular region. For calculating the factor K2, you will require the period of vibration. So the period of vibration I will calculate first. So the period of vibration is given as 6.35 into 10 to power minus 5 h by d raised to 3 by 2 and w by t raised to 1 by 2. So this is 6.35 into 10 to power minus 5. H is the height of vessel, which is 45 meters, and D is the diameter of the vessel, which is 3 meters, raised to 3 by 2, multiplied by the W, which is in kilonewtons, so that is given as 2500, divided by the thickness of the vessel, which is given as 10 millimeters, so that is 0.010 meters, so raised to half. So this gives me the period of vibration as 1.84 seconds. So this I will have to use for calculating the value of the factor K2. So the factor K2 is given in the previous table. So if you refer to the wind calculation, we'll find that the factor K2 is given as, for less than 0.5 seconds it is given as 1, and for more than 0.5 it is given as 2. In our case, the period of vibration is more than 0.5, so we'll be considering factor K2 as. So we'll go here. So this implies that factor K2 will be equal to 2. The factor K1 is a shape factor. So this is in the range of 0.7 to 0.85, where 0.85 corresponds to vessels with lot of attachments. So for our calculations, we are considering the factor K1 as 0.7, so that is assumed. Next, we'll require, we are having two sections, less than 20 meters and more than 20 meters as defined in the problem. So we have been given wind pressure greater than 20 meters and less than 20 meters. So we'll consider the vessel to be split into two parts. One is bottom 20 meters and remaining is upper 25 meters. So that is the two zones those we'll be considering. So let's proceed with that calculation. So the value of the bottom section, which I'm calling as PLW, will be given as K1, K2, lower section pressure, height of lower section, and outside diameter of lower section. So our K1 value we have assumed as 0.7, K2 value from period of vibration is 2. The pressure corresponding to height less than 20 meters is given as 1000 newton per meter square. The height of lower portion is 20 meters. We have split the vessel into two parts. One is bottom 20 meters and the other is top 25 meters. And the diameter of the vessel I am taking as 3 meters. So actually it is 3.02 meters. I am approximating it. So approximately, so we are approximating 3020 to 3 meters. So that won't make difference in the numbers that we are talking about. So this is 84,000 newtons. Similarly, the pressure in the upper section, will the load on the upper section would be given as 0.7 multiplied by 3 multiplied by the pressure there is 1500 newton per meter square multiplied by height. The remaining height from 45 meters when you take away 20 meters is 25 meters multiplied by the diameter which is considered. So this gives you the value of 157,500 newtons. So these are the loads which are acting on the bottom and lower section. So now we have to calculate what is the wind moment. So wind moment would be given as the lower portion multiplied by the lower height divided by 2. So we are considering, so this is h1 and this is h2. So h1 is 20 meters and this is 25 meters. So for bottom portion, we are considering the force acting on this portion. This is PLW multiplied by h1 by 2. So that is, so here we have to add the moment because of the upper section, which is given as PUW, upper load, multiplied by, so here we have to consider the height coming, the total height up to the base, so that is 20 meters plus h2 by 2. So by substituting the values, we will get 84,000 multiplied by 20 by 2 plus 157,500 multiplied by 20 plus 25 by 2. So this gives us the value as 5.959 into 10 to power 6 Newton meter. We'll be using a Newton millimeter as the unit, so it will be 5.959 into 10 to power 9 Newton millimeters. So that is the value of the wind moment. So stresses due to wind moment are given as FWB, which is equal to plus or minus 4MW divided by pi dsk square dsk. So that is m divided by section modulus. So that is plus or minus 4 multiplied by 5.959 into 10 to power 9 divided by pi multiplied by 3000 square multiplied by tsk. So this gives you the value of the FWB as plus or minus 843.0 divided by tsk. So we get the seismic moment in the seismic stress, the wind stress as given by this formula. Now we have to do the similar calculations, or we have to do the calculations for the seismic load. So let's do that. So we are having seismic load stresses. So the seismic moment is given as 2 by 3 CWH, where C is the seismic coefficient, which is given in terms of the zone and the period of vibration. So in our case, our zone is given as moderate and our period of vibration is calculated as 1.84 seconds. So we are having 1.84 seconds. If you refer to the seismic calculations, you will find this table. So we are having the moderate condition. So our condition is moderate and our period of vibration is 1.84 seconds. So our value will be 0.04. So C will be 0.04. So we'll be considering C. So corresponding to this, C equal to 0.04. So we'll get 2 by 3 into 0.04 multiplied by weight of the equipment, which is given as 2500 into 10 to power 3 multiplied by height of the vessel, which is given as 45 meters. So that is 45 into 10 to power 3. So that gives me the moment as 3 into 10 to power 9 Newton millimeters. So again, we will calculate the stresses similar to the wind case. So stresses due to seismic moment are given as FSB equal to plus or minus 4 times MS divided by pi dsk square and dsk. So if you substitute the values, you will find the answer is 424.4 divided by TSK. So we got the value of the deadweight stress, the bending stress due to wind and bending stress due to seismic load in terms of TSK. Now you have to combine them, find out what is the maximum tensile stress, what is the maximum compressive stress, compare with the allowable, and we will get the value of TSK. So the total stress, next we'll do the total stress in the skirt. So total tensile, first we'll do from tensile point of view. So total tensile stress in skirt. So that will be given as Ft equal to maximum of F because of wind, F because of seismic. They are tensile and the deadweight stress is compressive. So by substituting the values, we are having max of 843 divided by TSK, 424.4 by TSK minus 265.3 divided by TSK. So this gives you, the governing is because of wind, so it is 577.7 divided by TSK. So that is the total tensile stress. Since the tensile allowable is given in the problem as 140 MPa, so therefore we are having 140 equal to 577.7 divided by TSK, which will imply that TSK is equal to 4.13 millimeters. So if you go by the tensile consideration, you will have the skirt thickness as given as 4.13 millimeter. In almost all cases, the skirt thickness will be given by the compressive stresses. So this is just an academic exercise. So if you go for the calculations in terms of the compressive stresses, so if you calculate total compressive stress, so you have F compressive is again the max of FWB minus FWB comma FSB. And here it will get added to the deadweight stress. So if you do the calculations, you will get 1108.3 divided by TSK as the allowable stress. And since allowable compressive, so we have allowable compressive given as 60 Newton per millimeter square. If you substitute this into this value, you will find that you will get TSK as 18.1 5 millimeters, so which you can round to 20 millimeters. So you'll get that you, for this particular problem, you will require a skirt which is having a thickness of 20 millimeters. So we have completed the first part of the problem. Now next we have to move to the base plate design. So let's move to the design of base plate.